Welcome to Fix Sleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Playful Leprechaun. Chapter 1. Enchanted Encounter. In the heart of the ancient forest, where sunlight filtered through a tapestry of emerald leaves, Clara found herself following an elusive melody, a melodic dance of wind through the branches and the distant laughter of woodland creatures. As she ventured deeper, the air became charged with a sense of magic, a palpable energy that stirred the very essence of the enchanted woods. Clara, a captivating storyteller with a penchant for exploring the mysteries of nature, had a heart attuned to the whispers of the mystical realm. Her raven black hair cascaded down her shoulders, adorned with wildflowers as vibrant as the tales she wove. Her eyes, the color of a deep, moonlit pool, sparkled with an innate curiosity that drew her into the heart of the forest. On this particular day, the woods seemed to hum with an anticipation that matched the rhythm of Clara's heartbeat. She followed an uncharted path, guided by a call that resonated in the rustle of leaves and the enchanting chorus of songbirds. Little did she know, her journey would soon intersect with the whimsical world of the leprechauns. As Clara meandered through the ancient trees, the foliage shifted from ordinary greenery to an otherworldly display of iridescent hues. The sunlight filtered through the leaves in patterns that seemed to dance in harmony with nature's secret song. The very air, imbued with the scent of blooming wildflowers and the musky fragrance of moss-covered stones, invited her deeper into the magical embrace of the forest. It was in a small glade, bathed in a soft, ethereal glow, that Clara first caught sight of the mischievous leprechaun. Seamus, a sprite of diminutive stature, with a shock of fiery red hair and a pointed green hat, frolicked amid a patch of clover. His laughter, a blend of tinkling bells and the chuckles of a playful breeze, filled the glade with an infectious joy. Clara, her curiosity piqued, approached the glade with a cautious yet intrigued demeanor. Seamus, sensing the presence of an outsider, paused in his frolics and fixed his mischievous gaze upon the captivating storyteller. Their eyes met, and in that moment, a spark ignited, an unspoken understanding that transcended the boundaries between the mortal and magical realms. "Top of the morning to ye, lass," Seamus greeted, his voice carrying the lilting cadence of ancient tales. Clara, ever respectful of the beings that inhabited the mystical woods, offered a polite nod in return. "Good morrow, Seamus. I am Clara, a humble storyteller wandering these enchanted lands." "What brings you to this glade filled with such mirth?" she inquired, her words a gentle melody that seemed to harmonize with the natural rhythms of the forest. Seamus, unable to resist the charm of Clara's presence, decided to reveal himself fully. With a twirl of his emerald green coat, he approached her with a bow that belied his mischievous nature. "Ah, Clara, ye stumbled upon me secret haven of joy. I am Seamus, a leprechaun known for me playful antics and the treasures hidden in these woods." Intrigued, Clara couldn't help but smile at the impish leprechaun before her. "Treasures, you say? Pray tell, Seamus, what secrets do these woods hold, and what brings mirth to your heart?" Seamus, ever the master of mischief, chuckled as he spoke. "Ah, lass, the woods be filled with secrets aplenty, but I've got me own treasure tucked away. Would ye be keen on discovering it?" Clara, her eyes gleaming with curiosity, nodded in agreement. Little did she know that this encounter would set the stage for a magical journey where tales would intertwine and the true treasure of the enchanted woods would be unveiled. And so, in the heart of the ancient forest, where emerald leaves whispered ancient tales and the laughter of a leprechaun echoed through the glade, Clara and Seamus embarked on an enchanted encounter that would move their destinies into the very fabric of the mystical realm. Chapter 2. The Leprechaun's Challenge. As the sun dipped below the horizon, casting a warm, golden glow upon the glade, Clara found herself captivated by the mischievous charm of Seamus. The air, filled with the enchanting symphony of the forest, hummed with an energy that hinted at unseen wonders waiting to be unraveled. Seamus, his eyes gleaming with a playful glint, proposed a challenge, a contest of wits and tales that would test the mettle of even the most seasoned storyteller. Clara, her heart fluttering with excitement, accepted the leprechaun's proposition, for she knew that within the enchanted woods, every challenge was a gateway to new adventures. The glade, now transformed into an impromptu stage for their friendly competition, pulsed with an ethereal energy. The ancient trees, their branches swaying in anticipation, seemed to lean closer as if eager to catch every word of the tales that would unfold beneath their leafy canopy. Seated on a bed of moss, Clara and Seamus faced each other, their eyes locked in a silent agreement that this friendly challenge would be a celebration of the art of storytelling. The moon, a silver crescent in the indigo sky, cast a gentle radiance upon the glade, as if nature itself had dimmed its lights to lend an aura of mystery to the impending tales. Seamus, the embodiment of mischievous wit, began the contest with a tale of a leprechaun's escapades in a distant land. His words flowed like a babbling brook, carrying with them the nuances of humor and the whimsy of folklore. Clara, listening intently, couldn't help but chuckle at the leprechaun's clever wordplay and playful antics. Not to be outdone, Clara responded with a tale of a wise old owl who held the secrets of the forest within its ageless gaze. Her voice, a melodic cadence that mirrored the rustling leaves, wove a narrative of ancient wisdom and the symbiotic dance between nature and the creatures that inhabited it. Seamus, though mischievous, found himself enraptured by the depth of Clara's storytelling. And so, beneath the celestial tapestry of stars, the storytellers engaged in a friendly duel of words. The glade became a theater, and the tales, like spectral dancers, waltzed through the air, casting a spell that transcended the boundaries of the enchanted woods. Clara and Seamus, caught in the dance of storytelling, felt the invisible threads of camaraderie weaving between them. As the contest unfolded, the tales became a kaleidoscope of emotions. Laughter echoed through the glade, poignant moments tugged at heartstrings, and the ancient trees themselves seemed to sway in approval. The forest creatures, drawn by the magic of the storytellers, gathered in silent admiration, their eyes reflecting the flickering glow of fireflies. With each exchanged tale, the connection between Clara and Seamus deepened. The challenge, initially a playful endeavor, transformed into a shared celebration of the rich tapestry of stories that link the mortal and magical realms. The enchanted woods, their very essence resonating with the joy of storytelling, embraced the duo as kindred spirits bound by the magic of words. As the final tale reached its conclusion, the glade fell into a tranquil silence, broken only by the hushed whispers of the breeze and the rustling leaves. Clara and Seamus, their eyes still sparkling with the remnants of shared laughter, acknowledged each other's storytelling prowess with a nod of mutual respect. The moon, now a full orb of silvery brilliance, cast its gentle light upon the storytellers. Clara, feeling the ancient energy of the woods coursing through her veins, realized that this encounter with Seamus was more than a mere challenge. It was the beginning of an extraordinary adventure where tales would intertwine and the enchantment of the enchanted woods would reveal its deepest secrets. And so, beneath the celestial gaze of the moon, Clara and Seamus, storyteller and leprechaun, embraced the magic of their encounter, knowing that the true treasure lay not in elusive riches but in the shared joy of weaving tales beneath the emerald canopy of the enchanted woods. Chapter 3. Unveiling the True Treasure. The glade, still basking in the afterglow of storytelling under the moonlit sky, held an air of anticipation as Clara and Seamus contemplated the next chapter of their encounter. The ethereal connection forged through tales lingered in the enchanted woods, creating a silent dialogue between the storyteller and the mischievous leprechaun. Seamus, his emerald green eyes reflecting the luminescence of the moon, regarded Clara with a thoughtful gaze. "Ye be a gift, Clara, a talent for weaving tales that dances with the very heartbeat of nature. But every storyteller seeks something beyond the words, something hidden in the folds of the tales themselves." Clara, humbled by Seamus's words, met his gaze with a knowing smile. "Indeed, Seamus, every story holds a key, a glimpse into the essence of the storyteller and the mysteries that surround us. But tell me, mischievous leprechaun, what tales lie within the folds of your own story?" Seamus, for a fleeting moment, seemed to wear a mask of playful evasion, his eyes twinkling with a mix of secrecy and mischief. Yet, the camaraderie forged in the glade prompted him to reveal more of his enigmatic tale. With a dramatic flourish, he settled into a bed of clover and began recounting the folklore that intertwined with his existence. "Long ago, in the heart of these enchanted woods, a leprechaun clan lived harmoniously with the creatures of the forest. Our laughter echoed through the glades, and our mischievous pranks were but a symphony of joy in the ears of the ancient trees," Seamus began, his voice a melodic cadence that mirrored the rustling leaves. As he delved deeper into his narrative, Seamus spoke of the familial bonds that united the leprechaun clan and the sacred duty each sprite undertook, guardians of nature's treasures. The tale unfolded like a scroll, revealing the legacy of leprechauns who, despite their playful demeanor, carried the weight of a noble responsibility. In the midst of the tale, Seamus's eyes gleamed with a hidden sorrow. "But, Clara, the balance of our world shifted. As the mortal realm changed, so did the magical forces that govern these woods. The laughter of the leprechauns faded, and our treasures became elusive shadows of their former glory." Clara, sensing the poignant undercurrents in Seamus's tale, listened attentively. the enchanted woods, having witnessed countless stories, seemed to sigh in sympathy, their leaves rustling in harmony with the leprechaun's narrative. In the wake of this change, I found solace in the simple joys of laughter and mirth. Hiding treasures became not just a duty but a means of preserving the essence of our clan. However, the true treasure, the heartbeat of these woods, the camaraderie shared by sprites and storytellers alike, was fading like the last light of twilight. As Seamus concluded his tale, a somber atmosphere settled over the glade. The moon, now veiled by a wisp of cloud, cast a gentle glow upon the storyteller and the leprechaun. Clara, touched by the leprechaun's vulnerability, reached out with a comforting hand. Seamus, your tale is one of resilience and the enduring spirit that binds all beings in these enchanted woods. Your treasures may be elusive, but the true wealth lies in the connection we share, the stories we weave, and the magic that dances within every word. Clara spoke, her voice carrying the weight of understanding. Seamus, his playful demeanor momentarily replaced by a genuine warmth, nodded in gratitude. The glade, still and contemplative, seemed to absorb the essence of their shared moment. The enchanted woods, ancient witnesses to tales untold, embraced the storyteller and leprechaun in a silent acknowledgement of the truths unveiled. As the moon emerged from behind the clouds, bathing the glade in its silvery light, Clara and Seamus felt a profound connection, a shared understanding that transcended the boundaries of storyteller and leprechaun. The enchanted encounter, now enriched with the tapestry of their narratives, set the stage for the final revelation, the unveiling of the true treasure hidden within the heart of the enchanted woods. And so, beneath the celestial gaze of the moon, Clara and Seamus prepared to embark on the next phase of their extraordinary adventure, where tales would intertwine, mysteries would unfold, and the magic of the enchanted woods would reveal its deepest secrets. Chapter 4. A Friendship Forged in Stories. With the moon casting its silvery glow upon the enchanted glade, Clara and Seamus found themselves at the precipice of a profound revelation, the true treasure hidden within the heart of the enchanted woods. The air, still reverberating with the echoes of shared tales, held an electric charge, as if the very essence of the mystical realm awaited the unveiling of a long-guarded secret. Seamus, his emerald green eyes reflecting a blend of mischief and newfound camaraderie, rose from his bed of clover and regarded Clara with a thoughtful gaze. The mischievous leprechaun, who had initially presented himself as a keeper of treasures, was about to reveal a treasure far more precious than gold or jewels. "Clara," Seamus began, his voice carrying the weight of centuries-old wisdom, "Eve, listen to me tales with a heart as open as the sky above. The woods, these ancient witnesses to the dance of time, have embraced our encounter with a silent acknowledgement. Now, it's time to reveal the true treasure that binds us, friendship." Clara, touched by the sincerity in Seamus's words, felt a warmth blossoming within her heart. The ancient trees, their gnarled branches reaching towards the heavens, seemed to lean in as if eager to witness the unveiling of a friendship forged in the crucible of shared stories. The mischievous glint in Seamus's eyes softened into a genuine smile as he extended a hand towards Clara. In the heart of these enchanted woods, where tales intertwine and magic weaves its threads, let our friendship be the true treasure, one that transcends time, laughter, and the very essence of our beings. Clara, her eyes shimmering with the depth of emotion, accepted Seamus's hand with a nod of agreement. The glade, now bathed in the silvery radiance of the moon, witnessed the union of a captivating storyteller and a jocund leprechaun in a shared pact that echoed through the ages. As friends, we embark on a journey where the tapestry of our tales continues to weave. The enchanted woods, filled with secrets and mysteries, shall be our playground, and every rustle of leaves, every whisper of the breeze, shall carry the echoes of our shared adventures, Seamus declared, the sincerity in his words echoing through the glade. Clara, feeling the ancient energy of the woods resonating with their newfound friendship, added, "Together, Seamus, we shall explore the untold stories that lie within the heart of these woods. The mysteries that have been whispered among the leaves and the magic that courses through the very veins of nature shall be our guide." And so, beneath the celestial gaze of the moon, Clara and Seamus embraced the magic of their encounter, a friendship forged not in the pursuit of hidden treasures but in the celebration of shared tales and the camaraderie that transcended the mortal and magical realms. The enchanted woods, their very essence intertwined with the threads of Clara and Seamus's narratives, seemed to respond with a symphony of rustling leaves and the distant laughter of woodland creatures. The moon, now a benevolent guardian watching over their newfound bond, cast its glow upon the storyteller and leprechaun, sealing their friendship in the annals of the mystical realm. As Clara and Seamus ventured deeper into the heart of the enchanted woods, the glade faded into the embrace of the ancient trees. The tales that unfolded in their wake became part of the ongoing saga of the magical realm, whispered among the leaves and shared by creatures that called the mystical forest their home. And so, in the heart of the enchanted woods, where emerald leaves rustled with the wisdom of ages and the moonlit canopy held the secrets of the night, Clara and Seamus embarked on an eternal journey, an adventure where friendship, laughter, and the magic of shared stories would be the true treasures hidden within the embrace of the enchanted woods.